Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 13.4. The topic is Problem Solving in Reciprocating Pump. In the earlier lectures, we discussed the theory part of reciprocating pump and we solved few problems from the unionized question papers in the reciprocating pump. In this lecture also, we continue with the problem solving in the reciprocating pump. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the reciprocating pump. Example number 6, a single acting reciprocating pump has a plunger of diameter 300 millimeter and a stroke of 200 millimeter. If the speed of the pump is 30 rpm, and the actual discharge is 6.5 liters per second of water, find the coefficient of discharge, percentage of slip, if overall efficiency is 75%. What horsepower is required to drive the pump? If the suction lift is 4 meter and delivery head is 30 meter. This is from November 2013 question paper. The data given, diameter of the plunger is 0.3 meter, stroke length L equal to 0.2 meter, speed of the pump 30 rpm, overall efficiency 0.75, actual discharge 6.5 10 power minus 3 meter cube per second or 6.5 liters per second, suction head 4 meter, delivery head 30 meter. The area of the pump or the area of the plunger, A equal to pi by 4 d square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. The theoretical discharge Q theoretical equal to ALN by 60, so 0.07065 into L equal to 0.2, N equal to 30 divided by 60 equal to 7.065 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube per second or 7.065 liters per second. Then the percentage of slip Q theoretical minus Q actual divided by Q theoretical into 100, 7.065 minus 6.5 divided by 7.065 into 100 equal to 8%. Coefficient of discharge, actual discharge divided by the theoretical discharge equal to 6.5 divided by 7.065 equal to 0.92. The power required to drive the pump, so P equal to W, the specific weight W into discharge into head, suction head plus delivery head divided by overall efficiency into 1000. Substituting, specific weight is 9810 into 7.065 in 10 power minus 3 into 4 plus 30 divided by 0.75 into 1000 equal to 3.14 kilowatt. So, the answer to the problem, coefficient of discharge 0.92, percentage of slip 8%, power required to drive the pump 3.24 kilowatts. Example number 7, consider a double acting reciprocating pump running at 40 rpm. The pump delivers 1 meter cube per minute of water. The piston diameter is 20 centimeter and the stroke length is 40 centimeter. The delivery and the suction heads are 20 meter and 5 meter respectively. Calculate the percentage of slip and the power required to drive the pump. So, the data given are speed of the pump N equal to 40 rpm, discharge is 1 meter cube per minute, that is equal to 0.0167 meter cube per second, piston diameter 0.2 meter, stroke length 0.4 meter, delivery head 20 meter, suction head 5 meter. Area of the pump, so A equal to pi by 4 into d square, so 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. The theoretical discharge, Q theoretical equal to 2 ALN by 60, so 2 stands for double acting, so 2 into ALN by 60, so which is 2 into 0.0314 into 0.4 into 40 divided by 60 equal to 0.01675 meter cube per second. The percentage of slip, Q theoretical minus Q actual divided by Q theoretical into 100, that is equal to 0.01675 minus 0.0167 divided by 0.01675 into 100 equal to 0.3%. The power required to drive the pump, P equal to 2 times. So, 2 again stands for the double acting pump, 2 times of WQ into H, HS plus HD divided by 1000. So, 2 into 9.80. into 0.01675 into 5 plus 20 divided by 1000 equal to 8.2 kilowatts. The answer to the problem, the percentage of slip equal to 0.3%, power required to drive the pump equal to 8.2 kilowatt. Example number 8, a double acting reciprocating piston pump is pumping water. Diameter of the piston is 300 millimeter. Diameter of the piston rod, which is on one side of the piston, is 50 millimeter. The piston stroke is 380 millimeter. The suction and the discharge heads are 4.5 meter and 18.6 meter respectively. Find the work done by the piston during the outward stroke. What would be the work done, change in the work done for the inward stroke? So this is from May 2011 question paper. And the double acting pump, it is a double acting pump. Piston diameter D equal to 0.3 meter. Diameter of the piston rod equal to 0.05 meter. Stroke length L equal to 0.38 meter. Suction head is 4.5 meter. Delivery head is 18.6 meter. So this is the double acting pump. And here this is the piston rod. So piston rod of diameter 0.05 meter. Diameter of the cylinder is 0.3 meter. So this is the diameter of the piston or diameter of the cylinder. Now the work done during the outward stroke. So this is W A L H. So W into A into L into H. So W area equal to pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square into L into HS plus HD. Substituting 9810 into 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square minus 0.05 square into 0.38. L equal to 0.38 into H equal to 4.5 plus 18.6. So this is 5914.8 Newton meter or joules. Work done during the inward stroke. So during the inward stroke, this is W A L H. Now the area is only the area of the piston. So W into pi by 4 D square into L into HS plus HD. So this is equal to 9810 into 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square into 0.38 into 4.5 plus 18.6 equal to 6083.8 Newton meter. So work done during the piston during the outward stroke is 5914.8 Newton meter, and work done change for inward stroke is 6.083.8 Newton meter. So this is the work done for the inward stroke and this is the work done for the outward stroke. Example number 9. A double acting reciprocating pump is running at 330 rpm. Its bore and the stroke are 250 millimeter and 400 millimeter respectively. The pump lifts water from a sump 3.8 meter below and deliver it to a tank located at 65 meter above the axis of the pump. The length of the suction, the delivery pipes are 6 meter and 150 meter respectively. The diameter of the delivery pipe is 100 millimeter. If the air vessel of adequate capacity has been fitted on the delivery side of the pump, determine 1. Minimum diameter of the suction pipe to prevent the separation of the flow. Assuming the minimum head to prevent the occurrence of separation is 2.5 meter. The maximum gross head against, second point, maximum gross head against which the pump has to work and the corresponding power of motor. Assume that mechanical efficiency is 78% and slip is 1.5%. Atmospheric head equal to 10 meter and the friction factor is 0.012. This is from May 2013 question paper. So given data, it is a double acting reciprocating pump, speed equal to 30 rpm, diameter of the cylinder D equal to 0.25 meter, stroke length equal to 0.4 meter, suction head HS equal to 3.8 meter, delivery head HD equal to 65 meter, length of the suction pipe LS equal to 6 meter, length of the delivery pipe LD equal to 150 meter, diameter of the delivery pipe DD equal to 0.1 meter, separation head is 2.5 meter, mechanical efficiency is 0.78, slip equal to 1.5% and friction coefficient is 0.012. So area, first we calculate the area of the pump. Area of the pump equal to pi by 4 D square. So which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.25 square equal to 0.04906 meter square. In area of the delivery pipe, AD equal to pi by 4 DD square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 7.85 10 power minus 3 meter square. Then radius of the crank R equal to capital L divided by 2, 0.4 divided by 2 equal to 0.2 meter. Then minimum diameter of the suction pipe to prevent the separation. The separation may occur in the suction pipe at the beginning of the suction stroke where theta equal to 0 degree. So HEAS equal to LS by G into capital A by AS into omega square R into cos 0. So we substitute is cos theta, substituting theta equal to 0 degree. So HEIS equal to 6 divided by 9.81 into 0.04906 divided by AS. AS we do not know. So AS multiplied by 2 omega equal to 2 pi n. So 2 into 3.14 into n speed 30 divided by 60 whole square into r equal to 0.2 cos 0 equal to 1. So the HEIS equal to 0.0592 divided by AS. Now for no separation the suction pipe, H atmosphere minus HS plus HEIS equal to H separation. So substituting 10 minus 3.8 minus 0.0592 divided by AS equal to 2.5. So 0.0592 divided by AS equal to 10 minus 3.8 minus 2.5 equal to 3.7. So AS equal to, so rearranging and calculating, AS equal to 0.016 meter square. So once we have the AS, then we can calculate the diameter of the suction pipe. DS equal to square root of 0.016 into 4 divided by 3.14, which is 0.1427 meter. This is the diameter of the suction pipe to prevent the separation in the suction line. Discharge of the pump. So Q equal to 2 into ALN by 60. So which is 2 into 0.04906 into 0.4 into 30 divided by 60. Equal to 0.019624 metric cube per second. The gross discharge with this 1.5% slip, this is equal to 1.05 into 0.019624 equal to 0.01992 metric cube per second. So there is a slip, there is a loss of discharge. So we have to take the multiply by 1.015 parameter. Then total head of the pump. H equal to HS plus HEIS plus HFS. So HS is the suction head, HEIS is the suction head due to the reciprocating, and the HFS friction head, HD, HEAD into plus HFD. So loss of it in the friction delivery pipe. So HS equal to 3.8 meter. HEIS equal to 0.0592 divided by AS equal to 0.0592 divided by 0.016 equal to 3.7 meter. HFS equal to friction head. So 4 into FLS divided by 2GD into capital A by AS omega sin theta whole square equal to 0, because sin 0 equal to 0. Then HD equal to 65 meter, HEAD equal to 0 because air vessel is fitted in the delivery pipe. So considering all the parameters, so velocity of the water in the delivery pipe. So velocity of the water equal to VD equal to Q by AD. So 0.019624. Divided by 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 2.5 meters per second. Now, friction head in the delivery pipe, HFD equal to 4FLD VD square divided by 2GGD. So, substituting 4 into 0.012 into 150 into 2.5 square, VD equal to 2.5, LD equal to 150, F equal to 0.12 divided by 2 into 9.82 into 0.2. So, this is 22.93 meter. So the total head equal to 3.8 plus 3.7 plus 0 plus 65 plus 0 plus 22.93 equal to 95.43 meter. Power required to drive the pump. P equal to W into Q into H divided by eta M, mechanical efficiency, 9810 into 0.01992 into 95.43 divided by 0.98 equal to 23.91 kilowatt. Then the answer to the problem, diameter of the suction pipe 14.27 centimeter, total head 95.43 meter, power required to drive the pump 23.91 kilowatt. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. So you may find the fluid mechanics and machinery book. You refer to the book for additional problems in the reciprocating pump. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject fluid mechanics and machines. Until then, bye.